changes in COPA. Okay, and we already understood that. Maybe I'll just give you the overview in the next 5 minutes. So we discussed about COPA. There are two types of COPA. One is account based and second is cost based. Okay, so account based COPA is taking the values only from GL accounting. Okay, and whatever postings will go to account based COPA, they will go from GL accounting, and the postings will only go when the accounting document is created. Okay, but the problem is, if I want to have the data coming from other modules like sales for planning and even from controlling to understand the actual cost of that particular material, then I cannot go for account based COPA. I have to go for costing based COPA. So the values flow from other SAP modules, and that is the reason most of the customers who implemented COPA, they implemented costing based COPA. Okay, and then we understood that both the types of COPA are still available in SAP S/4HANA also. So in SAP S/4HANA, there is no change in cost based COPA. So cost based COPA is available as it is without any simplification. Simplifications are only available in account based COPA. Okay, what are the simplifications? The first simplification is simplified data model, which means till now there were a lot of tables which were completely independent of GL accounting, right? So if you are using COPA, there were a lot of different tables that were required only for COPA reporting. Okay, but now when we are talking about the simplified data model, all the data related to account based COPA also will get stored in one single table, that is ACDOC A. Okay, so all the information of account based COPA will now be available in ACDOC A. That is the first change. The second change is COGS split. Okay, what is COGS split? I will explain you now. We have not discussed the COGS split till now. We only discussed simplified data model till now. Okay, so if you remember in our last session, we activated the account based COPA for our company code. Let me just log off all these things and log in again to avoid any kind of communication, confusion. So confirm and okay. Yes, so in our last session, we already activated COPA via SPRO. We created the operating concern first of all, and then in controlling, we went to profitability analysis. We maintained the operating concern. So the operating concern that we maintained was SF01. And if you remember, we maintained the data structures. We only activated two characteristics. Okay, we only maintain characteristics KD, GRP, and LAND1. Okay, but what was happening? Whenever we were posting anything, we were not able to see these values, customer group and the country value. The reason was the characteristics was not defined properly. So I told you I will check in background and I'll let you know tomorrow or in the next session. So the problem was we were using some other field. I removed that field. Now I included this from KNA1. So initially when we added two characteristics here, both the characteristics were taking the values from table KNVV. Any idea what is table KNVV? What is table KNVV in SAP? KNVV is sales area data for customer. So you must be knowing KNA1 and KNB1. KNA1 is general data for customer and KNB1 is company code data. Right, there is third table which is for sales area data, and that is KNVV. So In our last session, when we created two characteristics, both the characteristics were taking the values from K and BV. And that is the reason they were not able to get the values, because we are still not maintained that customer for the sales area data. Okay, so if the system is trying to pick the data from K and BV and there is no data for that customer on K and BV, that is the reason system was not able to show us customer group. Okay, but then what I have done is I added some more columns here. For example, you can see region. So now this region, if you go to AC doc A table, and just specify your company code as SF01, and then I posted the last document as I think this one 18 all time 05, which is FB70 invoice. So if you click on online, now you will be able to see that the fields, there is a separate section for COPA fields in AC doc A table. Okay, so towards the end you will be able to see a lot of fields related to COPA. Not even this. Yeah, these fields, what you are able to see, these are COPA related fields. So here you will be able to see the region and country. See, these things are getting populated now. Why they are getting populated? Because earlier, why they were not getting populated? The reason was the origin table was KNVV table. Okay, so KNVV table was blank for that particular customer. And that is the reason system was not able to derive that information. But now, since it is taking from KNA1, and customer, whenever you create a customer, by default it is first created in KNA1 itself. So we have the country information and we have the region information, which is getting populated here correctly. Account group I activated later on. So maybe in this document you will not be able to see account group. Let's check. This I activated only after making this posting. So maybe the next posting that you will make, you will be able to see the account group field also. Let's see if account group appears here. No, it is not appearing because I made the posting first and then I added this field to my COPA characteristics. Okay, but anyways, you now understood that how these two fields are getting recognized, region and land one. This is because in my COPA structure, the data structure, the characteristics which are activated are taking the values from this main table, KNA1. Okay, so like this, whatever number of characteristics you want to see here, whatever number of dimensions you want to see in your COPA reporting, like for example, a funded program or maybe payer or group, you can see there are a lot of fields, customer group, production sale group. So most of these fields are actually coming from sales and distribution. See, profitability analysis, most of the information from the profitability analysis, you will get it from SD module. Okay, because we are talking about costing based COPA and even account based COPA, the things are like, whenever we use the costing based COPA, not only the accounting document, even if you create a sales order, that would be automatically available here as a COPA document. Okay, it will not come in AC doc A. Can you tell me why? Let's say I create a sales order. Okay, let me be slow. Let's say I created a sales order and that sales order is going to the costing based COPA reporting. Okay, but it will still not appear in table AC doc A. Can you tell me why? If you followed my session in last two sessions, if you followed me completely, then you will be able to answer this question. I activated costing based COPA as well as account based COPA. In account based COPA, postings to COPA will only go when you posted into the accounts. But values to costing based COPA will even go when you create a sales order, even if it is not posted to accounting. Okay, even if I activate costing based COPA for my company code and if I create a sales order, my costing based COPA report will definitely include that information. but that information will not come into AC Doc E. Can you tell me why? Anyone?
It is not posted. Maybe billing was not being done.
No, that is fine. It is not posted. That is the reason it is in the cost base, not in account. But my question is, values will come to AC Doc A or not? Why it will not appear in AC Doc A is because costing base COPA will not update anything in AC Doc A. Just remember this thing. Normally, if there is a confusion that all the COPA values will go to AC Doc A, that is wrong. Only account based COPA value will go to AC Doc A, not the costing based COPA. If you remember yesterday itself, we also discussed that costing based COPA is completely untouched. What do you mean by completely untouched? It means that whatever tables were there in ECC for costing based COPA, those are still available. So there is no entries of costing based COPA which will come to table AC Doc A. AC Doc A will only contain the information which is related to account based COPA. Clear on this? Any question here? Okay. So now we completed the understanding of simplified data model. What do you mean by simplified data model? Simplified data model means account based COPA will always update table AC Doc A, and the old tables which are related to account based COPA will not be updated anymore. And that is the reason there will not be any reconciliation issue between your COPA and FI. Okay, now let's talk about what is COGS split. This is the second functionality which is available in Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes, Gaurav.
Yes.
Yes, there was network issue. Okay, so I was talking about the second functionality or second simplification which is available on account-based COPA is COGS split. Okay, so before we understand what is COGS split, can you tell me what is COGS? What do you mean by COGS?
Cost of goods sold.
Cost of goods sold, right?
Yes.
What do you mean by cost of goods sold? When exactly come into the picture?
Raw material plus adding the value to this particular finished goods.
No, okay, but when exactly this will come into the accounting? When we debit or credit COGS account?
When goods are moving from the when goods are moving from the inventory to the customer.
Okay. Yes, Akash, you want to add something?
At the time of PGI.
At the time of PGI, right? So both the answers are correct. Normally, this COGS account will come into the picture at the time of PGI, which means whenever you create a sales order. Okay, the sales order is, once the sales order is created, it will be delivered, material will be delivered to the customer. And normally at the time of delivery, we have this PGI, which is nothing but post goods issue. So when you do the PGI, there is an accounting entry. The accounting entry is COGS debit and your inventory stock, whatever is your stock, whether it is finished good or it is trading good, it gets credited. Okay, so this is a common, you everybody I think must be knowing this, that this is a accounting entry when you do the PGI. So COGS is getting debited and stock is getting credited. Now let's talk about the COGS in detail. So COGS, as you said, it is cost of goods sold. Okay, let's say my this is a COGS for my finished good. Okay, so now let's say if this finished good was manufactured at the cost of 160 rupees, okay, which includes the material cost of 100 and labor cost of 60. Okay, so total cost of this finished good is 160, which is divided into material of 100 and then labor of 60. Now, where exactly we store this information? Any idea? In SAP system, where do we get this information, like how much is the material and how much is the labor? We do the costing, right? We do the product costing. In the product costing module, we have a cost component structure. Okay, so whatever finished good we are creating, normally we maintain the standard price. Okay, so what do you mean by standard price? Standard price means system will automatically calculate this amount based on the PP module. They maintain BOM and routing. What is BOM? BOM is bill of material. So whenever I am going to manufacture this particular finished good, what are the raw materials I need? That is managed in the BOM. And how much labor, how much machine, how much miscellaneous expenses I am going to incur, that is maintained in the routing. Okay, in the routing, you tell the system that what would be my method of manufacturing this particular material. So let's take a simple example. Let's say your company is manufacturing a computer. Okay, now in order to manufacture the computer, we need keyboard. First of all, we need CPU. We need keyboard. Okay, we need a mouse. We need a RAM, we need a hard disk. Okay, so let's assume these are the only components that we need. And then we need a process of assembly. Okay, so let's say CPU cost is 20,000. Keyboard cost is 500. Mouse cost is again 500. Your RAM is 5,000. And your hard disk is another 3,000. Okay, so what is the total cost of this material itself? Only material. If you just look at the material, so the cost of material is, let me write here, total material cost. Total material cost is 3,000. Sorry. I wanted this is 20,000, not 2,000. So 20,000 plus 1, 21, 21 plus 8. So total cost of material is 29,000. Okay, and let's say assembling. Now definitely you want a person who will be assembling this. If I just give you the raw materials, customer will not accept it. You cannot tell to the customer, take the raw material and assemble on your own. You want to make sure that assembling is also done. So this assembling, let's say, will cost me another 1000. Okay, so this information, in order to manufacture computer, what raw materials you need, this information is stored in BOM. These are all production planning related things which I'm talking to you. So in the production planning, there are two master data, BOM and routing. BOM means what materials I need to manufacture a particular finished good. And routing means what processes I need to carry out in order to complete the manufacturing process. Okay, so the total cost. So let's say this assembling is nothing but labor cost of 1000. So in this case, COGS is how much? Total COGS is 30,000, which is divided into material of 29,000 and labor of 1000. Okay, so normally whenever you do any PGI, what information you get? Do you get this information? You get only the COGS debit, or you can get material 29,000 and labor 1000 also as debit? Is it possible? If my customer is saying, I don't want COGS account to be debited in case of PGI, I want material consumption and labor consumption to be debited. Is it possible? Have you seen it somewhere? Whenever you do the PGI, instead of the complete COGS, it is getting splitted into material and labor.
No.
It is not possible, right? In SAP ECC, this particular thing is not possible. So if the customer is asking you, customer is telling you that I want to see out of my COGS, how much is material consumption, how much is my labor consumption. So in that case, in SAP ECC, the only option is to tell the customer, go to your costing based COPA report and there you will get this information. So in costing based COPA, this information is available always in ECC also. If you go to costing based COPA, because costing based COPA is not taking the values from accounts. In accounts, there is only COGS. We don't have this bifurcation. Okay, so in costing based COPA, it was possible to split the cost of COGS. But in account based COPA, this was not possible in ECC. But now, even in SAP ECC also, in S4HANA, even in account based COPA also, you can get this COGS split. Okay, so that is the second benefit of, or second simplification which is made in account based COPA when it is coming to S4HANA. So two things which were not possible in SAP ECC in account based COPA, those are now made available. The first thing which was always the problem was there was a lot of configuration required to activate account based COPA, unnecessary number of tables. And that is the reason customer we are saying, okay, no need to activate account based COPA. Let's just activate costing based COPA because that will give us better results. And second thing is, if you want to split your COGS, it was only possible in costing based COPA. And that is the reason customers were not activating account based COPA. But now SAP is saying there are two benefits of account based COPA and S4HANA. First one, you don't need to worry about the storage. Everything is getting stored in ACDoc, due to which you will not find any reconciliation issue. Configuration is very simple compared to SAP ECC. And then you can also get COGS split in SAP S4HANA system, even in account-based COPA. And that is the reason SAP is recommending that even if you are not using account-based COPA till now, start using it, because it will give you more reports on the profitability. Okay, because it is not taking you any much time for the configuration. It is even not asking you to store the data in the separate tables. So by just activating this, you can get many reports in profitability analysis. And that is the reason SAP is strongly recommending that go for account-based COPA. Even if you are using costing-based COPA, don't touch it. You can activate both account-based COPA also and costing-based COPA also. Okay, so this particular scenario, I was trying to configure in the system, but I'm still not able to configure everything because I have to configure MM, I have to configure SD, I have to configure PP, CO, right? Product costing and all. So a lot of things I have done, but I'm stuck at one place because of this server issue. So that is the reason what I'll show you is, maybe just give me the minute, I will show you one screenshot which I have done earlier. And I will try to see if tomorrow I'm able to show you in this system. So I already had the product costing available, bomb routing, plant, everything I have created for our company code, but I'm just stuck at the last stage. So maybe that is not very important. I can show you whatever I have done till now. So just give me a minute. I will just share that screenshot with you, which is related to the previous session. Just give me a minute. That is this one. Can you see this document? I think it is not very clear, but I'll explain you what we are talking about. Can you see this? Yes, sir.
Yeah, I have a doubt over here. So, like account-based COPA is it will only capture the financial accounting data, right?
Right.
So then, how this cost of material and labor will impact or capture in this process?
Yes. So earlier there was only COGS account was getting debited, right? Now wherever you do the PGI, even in your accounts also it will be getting bifurcated. It will show you material consumption 29,000, labor consumption 1,000, and then credit would be your stock. So instead of one single COGS account coming into accounts, it will be bifurcated into multiple GL accounts with debit entry. So still the values are coming from accounts only.
Okay, but the first statement, is it correct? The account based costing will only impact from the accounting perspective, because is it but if the second statement is correct, then it is impacting by the others module or other side also, right?
No, again, let me come to you. The first thing you are saying is it correct that my account based COPA will still match with GL accounts? That is completely correct. And the second statement is these values are coming from product costing, but if you see this, this is already posted. I'm saying this will be posted in accounts. Then only it will be available in account-based COPA. I think when you see this example, it will become more clear.
Okay, Gaurav. Okay, yeah, fine.
I'll show you what exactly I mean. So can you see this document now? Material cost estimate?
Yes, Gaurav.
See, what is happening here, I'm showing you this is a particular material. Okay, if it is not very clearly visible, don't worry. There is material number 12 for particular plant, COPA plant. Okay, and you can see here the product cost is 160. Total cost is 160, which is divided into 100 and 60. Now this is, as I told you, we need the configuration in product costing. Not only product costing, this raw material cost is coming from BOM, and this labor cost is coming from your routings. Okay, so all this information is coming from different modules. So total cost is 160. This is a planned cost for this particular material. And since this is a finished good, we normally use standard cost. Okay, we normally use standard cost in accounting. So now this information is available in the product costing, that out of 160, which is total COGS, how much is material and how much is labor. Only thing is, this is not coming in account-based COPA because account-based COPA was till this time only posting this total amount as COGS. But what we want, even in accounts also, based on this settings, system should post material cost separately and labor cost separately. Okay, so now you can see this sales order. We created a sales order. In the sales order, you have this price, VPRS. It is showing you 160. Okay, so the total cost of this particular material is 160. Now when you do the PGI, this is a PGI document, right? You can see stock is credited and material consumption. This is actually COGS. COGS gets debited. But now There is one configuration which is new. This was not available in ECC. Okay, so there is a new configuration called as configuration for COGS plate, which is available in this particular screen. I'll show you this in the system. So define accounts for splitting of COGS. Okay, and here what we have done is we have to create a scheme. Okay, so I'll show you how to create that scheme. But what is important is this one. So you can see here in the scheme, what we are saying is divide the cost of COGS based on the cost component. What are the cost components? These are created in product costing. Okay, so in product costing, again, if you go back, I've shown you this one here. So this is my product costing component. You can see 10, 20, 30. There are three components. 10, 20, 30. 10 is material, 20 is labor, and 30 is sales. Okay, in this case, there is no cost for sales, only labor and direct material, so which is 160. So instead of booking the complete COGS amount of 160, I want the system to divide that amount into cost component 10, cost component 20, and cost component 30. So that configuration, you can see here we have to specify. So you can see 10, 20, and 30. So this was my normal GL account, COGS account. You can see this is a COGS account. Now, whatever posting was going to in this COGS account, I want to divide based on whether it is coming from cost component 10 or 20 or 30. So what I'm telling the system is, instead of posting everything to one GL account, COGS, post it separately for material. So we have to create a new GL for material consumption, second GL for labor expenses, and third one for sales and marketing. And we are telling the system, based on this cost component structure, divide this amount. And once you do this configuration, see what will happen. Now, if you go to sales order, so total cost is 160, but at the time of PGI, instead of COGS, you can see the cost is divided into 160. So COGS is still appearing. You can see COGS is still there, but there are two entries, one for positive and one for negative. Okay, so the first system is posting stock to COGS, but then it is dividing COGS into material and labor. Okay, maybe I'll show you these things now in system, at least the configuration. So if I go for SPRO, the new configuration is available here in SAP reference financial accounting. You have this financial accounting global settings, ledgers. No, just 1 minute. General ledger accounting, periodic processing, integration. Okay, so this in integration, you have different types of integrations: asset accounting, materials management, sales and distribution. Let's go to the sales and distribution, or maybe you just go to materials management. Here there is define accounts for splitting of COGS. This particular configuration you will not find in SAP ECC. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to click here. First, create a new schema, okay, for a controlling area. So earlier it was called a scheme, now they've changed it to profile, but no problem, just click here. Let's say this is my profile is SF01, okay, and for controlling area also SF01. Now here I will go and specify source accounts and valuation views. Okay, so here my source accounts will come. What is my source account? It is nothing but my COGS account. And then here in the target accounts, I have to specify one by one. Actually, I need to create those GLs. Okay, in the target accounts, I will mention the things like this one. So where you need to specify which cost component structure, what would be the target account. Can you see this? These are my target accounts. So in short, instead of posting everything into one COGS account, in S4HANA, it is possible to divide or bifurcate that account into multiple subcomponents. Okay, so that whatever thing was only possible in cost-based COPA, when it comes to COGS split, now it can be also made available in account-based COPA. Sandeep, is your doubt clear now? So it is still coming from account is COPA, but only when this posting is already done into accounts. If the posting is done in accounts, then only it is matching with account based COPA. Clear on this? Yes, no. Any questions on this? What is COGS split now? Very important question when it comes to the interview. When you tell the interviewer that I know S/4HANA, so they can ask you what are the changes in COPA. So you have to be very clear. I'm again repeating whatever we have discussed till now in terms of COPA. Number one, there are two types of COPA: costing based, account based. No change in costing based COPA. Whatever changes are there, changes are in account based COPA. What are the changes in account based COPA? First one, simplified data model, which allows you simple configuration, and it allows you to reconcile the balances always with GL because the data is getting stored in one single table, ACDOC A. Second one, COGS split. So what is COGS split? COGS split means normally when we create a sales order and do the delivery, system, when you do the PGI, system will post the debit entry into the COGS account. Now, looking into the accounting, I cannot determine out of this total COGS, how much is my material cost, how much is my labor cost. If I want that information is only available in costing based COPA. That was always a problem with account based COPA. But now in account based COPA also, I can get the information that out of my total COGS, how much is belonging to material and how much belongs to labor. How that is achieved? That is achieved by the new configuration where you need to specify the GL accounts. What is your source GL account? Your source GL account is COGS account, and your target GL accounts are the cost component structures that you created in product costing. Clear?
So Gaurav, cost component structure will be GL account, right?
No, cost component structure, if you go to the product costing, let me show you. See, normally in product costing, if you go to controlling, product cost controlling, and product cost planning, this is a cost component structure where you define. See, I already created for our company and all, but in the last step, I'm getting some errors. So maybe I'll try to solve this and show you once again. And if I go with this one, so you can see here the components are raw material, wages, and welding. I just added this third component. So these are my three components. What I can do now is I can tell the system that my finished good is divided into raw material, into wages, and welding, or this can be any other kind of expense. Okay, and I want the system to determine the segregate my COGS account into raw material, wages, and welding. So whenever I'll go to that configuration of cost component split or COGS split, I will tell the system if my cost component is one, this means it should go to the raw material GL account. If my cost component is 30, it should go to the wages GL account. And if it is 50, it should go to the welding GL account. So this is how my cost of the entire product is divided. If I see, I had to do a lot of configurations, BOM, routings, and then only this will work. But if I show you CK11N, which is the transaction to derive the product cost. So for material number 84, which is the finished good that I created, and for plant SF01, if I press enter, see currently what is happening is I'm still not able to determine the labor cost. For material cost, it is working completely fine. So currently you can see the total cost of this material is only 1000. Why? Because this welding is still not taking any value. So if this welding starts taking value, let's say I want 500 is a welding cost and 1000 as a material, then I have two components. So my COGS will become 1500, 1000 would be material, and 500 would be wages. So according to that, I can divide my COGS. So COGS will be splitted based on this cost components.